The next group that we are discussing that is phylum Ctenophora. Phylum Ctenophora. Ctenophora, the commonly known as sea walnut or comb jellies. Sea walnut or comb jellies. They are exclusively marine, radially symmetrical, diploblastic, and body bears 8 external rows of ciliated comb plates. That's why their name is comb jellies. And the digestion is extracellular and the intracellular. And they have the ability to emit light. That's why it is have the property bioluminescence. Okay, sexes are not separate. Reproduction takes place by the sexual means. And the fertilization is external with indirect development. Again, I'm repeating the point. Phylum Ctenophora. Ctenophora, commonly known as sea walnuts or comb jellies. Marine, radially symmetrical, diploblastic. Body bears 8 rows of external rows of ciliated comb plates. And these comb plates are helps for the locomotion. See, the comb plates are ciliated. That means the cilia are help the organism to move. And the digestion extracellular and the intracellular. These are the organism phylum Ctenophora. So this Ctenophora organism have the ability to emit light. Okay, the capacity to emit light or the property that is known as bioluminescence. Bioluminescence, and it having the 8 rows of ciliated comb plates. Okay, these comb plates are help the organism for movement. The sexes are not separate and the reproduction takes only by the sexual means. Fertilization is external with indirect development. Okay, this is a textbook picture of the group, not group, phylum Ctenophora. Pleurobrachia and Ctenoplana are the examples for the group phylum Ctenophora. Pleurobrachia and Ctenoplana. Ctenoplana spelling Ctenoplana. Ctenoplana. Okay. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 rows of comb plates. Okay. From there, the ciliated structure arises. The ciliated structure had the organism to move. And we discuss the stages: bioluminescence, hermaphrodite, sexual reproduction, external fertilization, and internal development occurs. The larval stage of this organism is cydipid larva. The larval stage of Ctenophora, that is cydipid larva. Larval stage of this organism is cydipid larva. And the example for this group is Ctenoplana and the Pleurobrachia. Ctenoplana and Pleurobrachia. The next phylum that we are discussing. The next phylum is phylum Platyhelminthes. Platy, that means flat. Okay, so phylum Platyhelminthes. So it is an flat worms. So Platyhelminthes onwards, the organism developing. Okay, evolution will take place. So, bilateral symmetry is the character of a chordata. Chordata means humans, mammals, all are included in the group chordata. So, bilateral symmetry is an advanced character. That advanced character seen in the group Platyhelminthes. So, the phylum Platyhelminthes contain bilateral symmetry and they are triploblastic. Triploblastic means 3 germ layers, ectoderm, endoderm and mesoderm. Okay, 3 germ layers will be seen. And this organism have no coelom. Coelom is the cavity. Okay, only one group that have no coelom, that is Platyhelminthes. So no coelom, the term is acoelomate. And here the organ level of organization will occur. Okay, we studied cellular level, tissue level, and here onwards organs will be start to develop. So organ system of organization will be seen in this group. Then the next is These organisms are parasites. Endoparasites means, endo means inner. So these organisms are seen inside the body, including human beings. Including the human beings, these organisms are seen inside and they act as parasites. Okay, so the organism are parasites. They have the hooks and suckers. Hooks and suckers. Hooks for attachment and sucker for sucking the blood or sucking the food materials. Okay, so this group mostly endoparasite with hooks and suckers. Then the next feature, the important feature, that is some of them absorb nutrient from the host directly through their body surface, and they have osmoregulation, and the excretion takes place by a special type of cells that is known as flame cells. So in case of platyhelminthes, the excretion and the osmoregulation takes place with the help of flame cells. Here the sexes are not separate. Fertilization is internal. Development occurs through different larval stages. Okay, and some members like planaria. Planaria is an example for platyhelminthes. Planaria shows high capacity of regeneration. Regeneration means if we cut the planaria body into different parts, each part forming the lost word. Okay, that is regeneration capacity. You saw that house lizard, they have the capacity to remove their, cut their tail. Okay, automatically the tail will be forming. On that way, when we are cutting the planaria into so many pieces, the planaria forming, the planaria's body forming the lost part. Then the next is cephalization. Cephalization means anterior and posterior end is forming. Anterior and posterior end. Okay, that is cephalization. Once again, I am repeating the points of phylum platyhelminthes. Bilaterally symmetrical, triploblastic, acoelomate, organ level of organization. Then the endoparasites. Endoparasites means they have hooks and suckers. Cephalization is present. Incomplete digestive system. Osmoregulation and excretion takes place by flame cells. Flame cells are the specialized cells. Through the flame cells, excretion and the osmoregulation will take place. Okay, the space between the body organs, the space between the body organs and the body wall, that is known as mesenchyma. Clear it is? The space between the body organs and the body wall, that is known as mesenchyma. Sense organs are simple. Sexes are not separated. Internal fertilization. Okay, direct development. Direct development means there is no larval stage. Internal fertilization means the fusion of egg and sperm occurs inside the body. Direct development means there is no larval stage. The life cycle completed, often involving several hosts. Okay, sometimes human will be a host for this organism. The regeneration capacity will be seen in planaria. Planaria will show high regeneration capacity. Okay, then the example for this group is fasciola. Fasciola commonly known as liver fluke. The next example is tinea. Tinea commonly known as tapeworm, nadavira. Okay, the next one is schistosoma, blood fluke. These are the common examples of phyla platyhelminthes. Fasciola, tinea, schistosoma. So these are the common examples for the group phyla platyhelminthes. Platyhelminthes is the only organism which have acoelomate. Acoelomate means there is no coelom. That condition is known as acoelomate. Clear it is? Okay. And the next phylum is Eshelminthes. Next phylum is Eshelminthes. Or otherwise, this Eshelminthes group is known as Nematoda. Free living, aquatic, terrestrial. Commonly, these nematoda are known as round worms. Okay, tube within a tube body plant. This nematoda means tube within a tube body plant. That means tube like structure. Bilateral symmetry, triploblastic, pseudocoel. Pseudocoel means here they have no pure cavity. Okay, coelom like structure will be seen. That is known as pseudocoel. Well developed alimentary canal. Alimentary canal, function of alimentary canal for digestion. So the well developed alimentary canal will be seen. And the respiration, circulation that are absent in this group. Okay, so what are the features? Free living, aquatic, terrestrial, roundworms, tube within a tube body plant. Sometimes it will ask you which organism or which phylum contain tube within a tube body plant. So example, that is nematoda group contain the tube within a tube body plant, and it is a pseudocoel. Alimentary canal, complete well developed alimentary canal will be seeing. Respiratory and circulatory systems are absent. Okay, and the body wastes are removed by the excretory tube through the excretory pore. So excretion will takes place through the body contains some pores. Through the pores, the excretion material will goes outside. Females are longer than males. Your textbook having the picture of Ascaris. Ascaris, example there is Ascaris. So the females are longer than male. Females are longer than male. That is sexual dimorphism. Sexual dimorphism means we can through morphologically we can assemble that this is a male organism and this is a female organism. So morphologically we can distinct the male and the female organism. That is sexual dimorphism. Okay, internal development. The common example for this group is Ascariasis. Ascariasis is commonly known as common roundworm. Common roundworm. Then Wuchereria, filarial worm. Wuchereria, filarial worm. It will cause the disease. Wuchereria bancrofti, which causes the disease. Elephantiasis, mand, filariasis. Okay, elephantiasis or filariasis. Otherwise, in Malayalam, we are telling the disease mand. Then the encyclostoma, commonly known as hookworm, and enterobios, that is commonly known as pinworm. And these are the examples for the group phylum Ashelminthes. Ascaris, common roundworm. Wuchereria, filarial worm. Encyclostoma, hookworm, and enterobios pinworm. Okay, so here I am winding this portion. Hope you will understand all these topics very well. Thank you.